You're very welcome back to Unstable TV. If this is your first time on the channel, do not forget to
like, subscribe, comment, share, hit that bell. And if you're a returning viewer, thanks.
We appreciate all the suggestions coming in from you guys on our Islam reaction videos. And we have another one here today. So what are we reacting to today, Danielle?
So today, James, we have been sent How Islam Began in 10 Minutes. Even though the video itself is only 8 minutes long. Where the other 2 minutes go, I don't know. But this is the video we've been sent.
Time is different.
Exactly. So how did Islam begin?
Let's find out.
How Islam began in under 10 minutes. Not a problem. We've started. Mm-hmm. Okay, so travel back in time with me to a land far, far away and long, long ago. Mecca and Arabia, about the year 570. Mecca is important for two reasons. One, the Kaaba is there, an ancient temple built to worship God. And two, Muhammad, peace be upon him, was born in Mecca. Now, problem. I can't show you Muhammad, because it wouldn't be right. I'll tell you why in a bit. But in the meantime, here's his name in Arabic. Nice. Back in the day, Mecca was a lawless place. The only way to be safe was to have backup. Lots of rich big brothers who'd beat up anyone who got in your way. So the place was ruled by the most powerful families who could do pretty much what they wanted. And religion didn't help. By this time, the Kaaba had been filled to overflowing with 360 idols that did nothing to help anyone. So it was a tough place to grow up if, like Muhammad, you were a poor orphan and believed in just one God you couldn't see, like the Jews and the Christians. He called him Allah. The God, in Arabic there. Muhammad's dad died before he was even born, and his mum died when he was just 6. So he was brought up by his grandfather, Abdul Muttalib, and then, when he died too, by his uncle, Abu Talib, who had the respect of the city's ruling families, so Muhammad was safe for the time being. Muhammad started out as a shepherd, and then became a businessman, travelling about buying and selling stuff for rich clients. When he did some work for a rich widow called Khadija, she was so impressed by his honesty and skill that they ended up getting married. And for a while, it looked like Muhammad was going places. Well, he was, but not how you think. Every year in the month of Ramadan, different calendar, different names for the months, there was a big party around the Kaaba when people made sacrifices to the idols. Muhammad hated it, so he'd get out of town and sleep in a cave he'd found on top of a nearby mountain. One night, Muhammad's praying to Allah when wham! There's the angel Jibreel, you might say Gabriel, standing right in front of him. Read, says the angel, but Muhammad couldn't read. No schools, you see. Jibreel keeps on at him. Three times he says, read. Then he grabs hold of Muhammad and wham! Again, it's like Muhammad's learnt the words off by heart. So he recites the message out loud. Read in the name of your Lord, who created man from a drop of blood. Read, for your Lord is most generous. He who taught by the pen, taught man what he did not know. It was a message from Allah. God was speaking to him, just like he'd spoken to the prophets in the Jewish and Christian holy books.
Just when she said, he created man from a drop of blood. Did we not do a video a couple of weeks ago where they said they created man from clay?
Yeah, that's what I said in the other Islam video we done.
Yeah.
It's a bit confusing.
So, people just let us know in the comment section what it actually was, because they're two very different things. So.
Yeah, we'll drop the playlist on the cards, and if you guys want to check through it and come back here.
Yeah, we'll put the video that we're talking to just up there.
Yeah.
Because, that's just a bit confusing, because what one was actually them, because...
Yeah, we're hearing another. So, see, this is what we're saying to you guys in the comments, and you're kind enough to come back and answer the questions with us. And we appreciate our member that is answering questions as well to us. We appreciate you a lot for that when we're trying to find our way with this. Every time we get a new video of you guys, we're getting something different. Because this is like, we were sure of what way the teachings were. Now it's something different. But this is the joy of learning.
Exactly. So just like we said, let us know in the comment section.
And we get back into this.
But he was a prophet too. The messages continued for the rest of Muhammad's life. Allah gave him the words to say and the Prophet recited them. The words were written down by his friends and years later they were collected together and became the Muslim holy book, the Quran, which means recitation, because Muhammad recited it, you see? Anyway, that was much later, so back to the night of power. Muhammad tells his family, then his friends, and eventually everyone about Allah, that he's the one and only God, that he wants everyone to be treated fairly, and long story short, it didn't go down well with the ruling families of Mecca, who liked things just the way they were, thank you very much. You see, Islam means obedience to Allah, and Muslim means someone who obeys Allah, and the ruling families didn't want anyone obeying anyone else but them. So the people who believed in Muhammad's message, the Muslims, were given a hard time. Some were even tortured and killed. A few of them managed to escape to Abyssinia, Ethiopia. But most were stuck in Mecca. Muhammad also had to cope with the death of his wife, and then just a few weeks later, his uncle too. Feeling very down, he went to the Kaaba to pray to Allah one night. Then, the weirdest thing happened. Jibreel turns up, sits him on a winged horse called Al-Burak and flies him all the way from Mecca to Jerusalem. He prays with all the prophets who have ever lived. Then, he's taken up to the heavens to chat with some of the prophets, and then into paradise itself, where Allah tells Muhammad to pray 5 times a day and to stay strong. He's returned to Jerusalem and then flies back to the Kaaba in Mecca. We call it the night journey, and Muslims still argue whether it was a real experience or a vision, but whatever, it gave Muhammad a much needed boost, and just as well, because there were more tough times ahead. So, there was this other city called Yathrib. The people there heard about Muhammad and his message, and invited him and his followers to join them. A few at a time, the Muslims left Mecca and made a dangerous journey across the desert to Yathrib. It's known as a hijra, which means migration, you know, like birds do. Muhammad and a few of his friends stayed in Mecca until everyone had got away and then made plans for their own escape.
Okay.
But the ruling families wanted to kill Muhammad while they still could, so 7 sons, one from each family, were sent in the middle of the night to stab the prophet while he slept. But he was way ahead of them, and when they burst into the house, Muhammad was gone. Trackers were sent out to hunt him down. Muhammad and his best friend Abu Bakr took a roundabout route to try and shake off the pursuit, but the trackers were too good and slowly gained on them. So Muhammad and Abu Bakr hid in a cave and prayed that no one found them. The trackers found the cave alright, but they didn't bother going in to search. There was no way Muhammad could be inside, they thought. There was a spider's web over the mouth of the cave and a nesting bird at the entrance. He must have given them the slip. So off they went, leaving Muhammad and Abu Bakr protected by a spider. Muhammad made it safely to Yathrib, which was renamed Medina al-Nabi, the city of the Prophet, but most people just call it Medina. But Muhammad's worries weren't over yet. There were 3 big battles between the Muslims and the Meccans. First, the Battle of Badr, when Muhammad and just 313 men faced 1,000 Meccan soldiers. Miraculously, the Muslims won. Then, there was the Battle of Uhud, which didn't go so well. Some of Muhammad's men disobeyed his orders and ran off during the battle to raid the Meccans' camp, and so the Muslims were outmaneuvered. Then there was the Battle of the Trench. Medina was protected on 3 sides by mountains, so when the Meccan forces advanced in the city, the Muslims just dug a deep trench. The Meccans made camp, but the weather was terrible. Pouring rain put out their fires and howling winds blew down their tents. Eventually, they gave up and went back to Mecca. It was all a bit embarrassing. They were losing the respect of the local tribes who were flocking to join the Muslims. So a peace treaty was signed at Hudaybiyah, but it wasn't long before the Meccans broke it. Muhammad decided that enough was enough. By now he had over 10,000 men, so he led them across the desert to Mecca. The ruling families realized they'd made a huge mistake, but it was too late. All they could do was surrender and hope that the Muslim army killed them quickly. But Muhammad said there should be no more fighting. He rode into Mecca and went straight to the Kaaba. He circled it 7 times anti-clockwise and smashed all the idols, rededicating the Kaaba to Allah. And that's why I'm not going to show you Muhammad. The Muslims wanted to make it totally clear that they only worship the one unseen God. So, they didn't have any pictures of Muhammad, in case anyone thought he was an idol, and they didn't have any pictures of Allah, because he's like nothing on earth, so it would be impossible to draw him anyway. So there you go, how Islam began in under 10 minutes. How did I do?
So first off, a very, very big shout out to the original content creator, and thank you guys for coming in to our Islam reactions and suggesting this to us. All right, a lot of information packed in here, and we didn't realize Muhammad, he lost a lot of his guardians very early, people who were raising him. And the story is pretty sad, to be honest, and it sounds like he was a bit of a loner, and then he came to him after basically like a prophet and came to the people. That's what it sounds like.
Yeah.
But I will say one thing at the end, just get this in before. That was a bit unfair to destroy every other idol and just force, because unfortunately, call it what you want, it's like when we watch Christianity videos as well, when they destroy other things and put their own religion in place. That's forced.
We understand that religious people want other people to understand their religion, but it can't be you have to go by this religion and that's it.
Yeah, it sounds like he became the brothers that, and the rich families that he was sworn to get away from. He had to keep leaving and coming back. It sounds like in the end he just became them.
Yeah, a little bit. He kind of just destroyed everything they believed in and just had that.
Yeah, it sounds like he just replaced. It sounds like business taken over, because he was a businessman as well.
Yeah.
As we heard.
Mm-hmm. Unless we're picking that up wrong. Unless that, because we don't know. Was that black box that was there? I can't remember what the name it is.
Yeah.
Was that just specifically for Allah in the beginning? And then they started putting things around it that wasn't to do with the Muslim religion? Or was it to do with something else first?
Yeah.
Because if it was just to do with Allah and the Muslim religion, and then they start putting other religions on top of it, you can understand why he wants to remove that. But if it was just for
idols,
yeah, then it's what I don't really...
Yeah, we know it's a temple, and that's, you know, that was sacred ground for them. But that's what we're trying to figure out. Did we pick it up wrong that Allah was their force and they replaced Allah, or...
Which way? Because that wasn't kind of really explained there, so which...
Yeah.
Which one was it, really?
Because it was basically they were worshipping idols or false gods, as it's saying. But was Allah in there forced, and that's what the Muslims were worshipping there, but the rich families were stopping them. So the Prophet Muhammad came in and reversed that. Have we picked that up wrong? Is there more we need to look into? We're trying not to be disrespectful either, while keeping an open-minded opinion here as well, because as we say, we are atheists ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
We don't believe in any religion, but we love learning about everyone's religion and their perspectives, and why anyone follows anything, because it's a big world out there and there's a lot to learn.
Yeah, 100%, because it wasn't like the story of Muhammad there was, it wasn't a million miles away from the story of Jesus either.
Yeah.
So.
It's equally a hard story. As you see, he goes through a lot of trials.
Mm-hmm.
The world does trial him a lot, and in the end, it's for the people and for the Muslims that he's trying to take it back. That's the way it's coming across.
Yeah,
100%. So let us know your thoughts in the comments down below. That's been our 2 cents, and we'll chop ourselves out.